What's up, y'all? It's Shyla, Shy, 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 whatever you want to call me, it's me, and I'm back with another motherfucking video. Period. So as you guys see the title, like always, tonight is going to be a story time high edition. So basically, I didn't roll yet. Normally, I would like to roll first because I just like to get the video started, but like, oh, if this video is not too long, at least if I like roll a spliff, it's gonna add some content and then it's gonna mismatch and it's gonna be perfect. You feel me? So no time to waste. We're gonna start right now because your girl needs to smoke. So if y'all smoke, please grab your whatever you got, roll it up, and let's get motherfucking high. Cause that's on period. Poop. Poop, poop, baby. I love you. Okay, so right now I'm smoking some Island Rock. It's pretty good weed, like, it's really good. And I'm gonna put a little bit of grappa in my slip as well. Do you guys use grappa in your slip? I know some people don't like grappa. I mean, I do. Very cool. That's a lot, because it's kind of compact, so I don't think I need to burn it. It's already freaking dry. You said what? Okay. So I put some pieces of gravel in here. So let's grind this motherfucker. Baby, I love you. Let's get to it. Okay, so I got my paper. And I got my filter. Do you guys roll without filter? I mean, every time I tried, it was, like, impossible. I could roll blunts and, like, hemp wraps and stuff without filter, but, like, paper, I don't know, I can't. It's just, it'd probably be weird, like, why is there no filter in the spliff? Like, the paper gonna get soggy, like, what? No, boo. No, 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 this is gonna be a big-ass spliff. I don't know if I might put all. We'll see how I'm feeling because sometimes it's like it's a lot. But I think this is exactly what we need for this motherfucking video. If you guys are new to my channel, it's the first time you guys are seeing my face. What's up, guys? What's up? If you guys are watching this and not subscribed, please go subscribe and yo, smash that like button. Guys, look at this lift. As soon as it's rolled, we're gonna get started into story time because let me tell you, this experience was crazy and never again will I ever do that. I learned my lesson, for sure, for sure. Like, that's gonna be like, what the fuck was wrong with you? Guys, don't come for me. Don't worry, y'all will know everything. Let me just spark this motherfucker. Let's get right motherfucking started into this motherfucking video. Period. Yo, if you guys wear lashes and smoke weed, have you ever burned a lash? Like, sometimes I have lashes and it's, like, kind of crispy because I literally burn my lashes while smoking. Alright, so y'all ready? Bet. Okay, so basically, this was, like, a few months ago and I was sleeping. I deadass was sleeping and I got out of bed to go take a shit, guys. Yeah, so I got up to take a motherfucking shit. And then my doorbell rings. So I'm like, what the hell? Who the hell's on my door, you know? So then I'm like, maybe it's my mom, or at that time I was dealing with somebody. So I assume maybe it was him, you know? Cause it was like 3 o'clock in the morning. And who the hell else would ring on my doorbell at that time, you know? I wasn't expecting company. I was dead ass sleeping and I got woken out of my sleep to go to the bathroom. And then, so anyways, doorbell rings. I go to the freaking door. And there's this girl outside my house, and she's like, she looks like she was crying and shit. And I asked her, I'm like, hi, can I help you? She's like, trying to basically come in. And I'm like, I don't know, like, can I help you? And like, she wasn't even saying anything. So I'm like, are you okay? Like, you need help. And like at that point, like I was like half asleep, so I wasn't really all there. So anyway, she was like not really giving me an answer. I'm like, I've been in a position, this will be a story time soon, with my ex, where like I was like basically outside looking for help in a way. Don't worry guys, not looking for help, but like I wish I would have had someone to be there for me in a way, you know. But like anyway, so like I felt kind of bad because she didn't look good, you know. So I'm like, oh my god, okay. So I brought this girl in my fucking house. She came in my house. That was the worst mistake I've ever made in my whole entire life. And let me tell you, I don't know who the hell the girl is, you know? Okay, so basically, she comes in and she sits on my couch and, like, she's, like, crying. But not crying, but, like, she's whining and she, you know? So I'm like, are you okay? Like, can I help you with something? Need to call someone? Do you, like, you know, like, what's up? Like, what's wrong? And she wasn't telling me anything. This girl asked to use my washroom, so I'm like, I bet, whatever. It's right there. So yeah, so she asked to use my washroom, and I'm like, okay, whatever. And while she's in the bathroom, I post on my Snap. Oh no, that wasn't yet. Okay, sorry, rewind. While she's in my bathroom, I was just out here, whatever, waiting for her to come out. And like, I hear a whole bunch of shit falling on the floor. And like, in my bathroom, on my toilet, like on top of the toilet, I have like a basket where I keep like my hair products, or it was either makeup at the time. Don't know, doesn't matter. Anyways, she comes out the bathroom, comes out on the couch, and I go to look in the bathroom. Everything was literally on the floor. Like, that was on top of my toilet. Everything was on the floor. So I was like, what the hell? Maybe she dropped it. I don't know. But anyways, like, it was just an odd vibe, you know? This girl, she's like, she needs to charge her phone because her phone was dead. So I let her use my charger. And bro, this girl falls asleep. I was like, what the fuck? Like, this girl didn't look okay. Like, it looked like she was, like, off drugs, drunk as hell. Like, you can smell the liquor off her mouth. Like, she wasn't good, you know? So, when she falls asleep, I go on my Snap and I post in my private story. And I'm like, yo, there's this girl in my house and she fell asleep. And I don't know who she is and, like, she doesn't want to wake up. So everybody on my Snap was like, what the hell? Get out of her house or wake her up or... And then I'm like, someone was like, tell your mom. So if you guys don't know, my mom was upstairs and I live in the bachelor. So basically I called my mom. Let me tell you, it was 3 o'clock in the morning. I called her, I'm like, mommy, I left some girl in my house cause she didn't look okay, you know? And now she's like sleeping on my couch and she doesn't want to wake up. And like at that time I worked. So the next day I had to be up early, you know? So my mom comes downstairs and it's kind of hard to wake her up. Like she was like really effed up. Like, so finally she wakes up and she's there about, I'm sorry, like she kept saying I'm sorry. And I'm like, are you okay? And my mom's like, do you need a ride somewhere? I can give you a ride. Like, where do you live? Are you from here? Like, and she kept saying I'm sorry. And then like she was looking on her phone and she's like, okay, I'm gonna go. She unplugs her phone, unplugs my charger. I'm like, no girl, that's my charger. Like, no. She takes my charger. I'm like, okay, girl, whatever, that's my charger. I take my charger. And then she ends up leaving. And me and my mom, like, we come back in my apartment. We're there discussing about what the hell just happened. And then I hear a knocking on my door. I'm like, oh my gosh, she's back. So then, like, we open the door. And she's crying at the door. And she's there about, someone sent me here. I'm like, what the hell? She was like, someone sent me here. And she caught an Uber here. And like I was so confused, kind of like, who the hell? And then like I don't remember much, but because I was so tired. And like I remember she was on her phone and I guess she was looking for contacts or for someone, I don't know. I don't know, like I really don't understand what the hell was going on, literally. And then she starts saying how like someone sent her here. And then I'm like, who? And then I'm like, what's your name? And then she told me her name. I'm not gonna say it. She tells me her name, and then she mentions someone that I know. So I was like, the hell? So my friend dated that girl. So like, I called my girl, and I'm like, yo, there's someone here that has this name that's said that this person sent her here. Like, that person sent her here to my house by Uber. So I'm like, what the hell? So I made my friend call her, and she's all confused about, like, no, like, what the hell? I never did that, but like, it's so crazy because that girl lives literally down the street from me. So it would have made sense if maybe by accident, like, she put the Uber to my house. But she was like, no, like, I wasn't even with her. I don't know really the actual story at the end of the day. But anyways, like, she ended up leaving because she couldn't stay at my house. And then, like, she leaves, and my mom goes back upstairs. Why does this girl come back ringing down my mom's doorbell? My mom's doorbell. She was literally ringing down my mom's doorbell, and I'm like, my mom calls me, and she's like, this girl came back to the house and started ringing down the doorbell. I'm like, what? And after that, like, she ended up leaving. And then, like, she was, like, just walking all over the street. And it's so crazy because I have a friend that lives down the street, and she told me that she came to her house too. I forgot to tell you guys because I'm freaking high. It actually turns out that I know the girl. Well, I don't know her. I was at the club once, and she was with, like, my group. And, like, I was, like, talking to her during the night. But, like, she just looked so different. So I was kind of, like... like, I really had no idea it was her. It was just so crazy. So then, like, anyways, she ends up, like, I only found out that, though, like, 2-3 days later. So, like, she comes back to my mom's house, and then my mom calls my landlord. Oh, no, that's not even what happened. This girl started bringing down my neighbor because, like, literally, I'm downstairs. My landlord is in the middle with her son, and my mom's upstairs. So then at first she started ringing down my mom's, then she started ringing down my freaking landlord's doorbell, and her son, like, he came out, and, like, he's, like, my age, and he's, like, cussing her out in French. It was just so crazy, and, like, it's not even like she was asking for help. She was literally just coming literally to cause trouble for what? She wasn't, like, everybody was offering her a ride home, and she wasn't taking it, and my girl that lives down the street was saying how, like, she came at her door, knocking at her door, asking to use the phone, and then, like, they let her use the phone, and then, like, she was trying to stay in, but they were like, no, you can't stay in here, you have to, you know, you can't stay here, whatever. And there, my girl was telling me how, like, she was laying all over their car and shit. Like, she was really out of it. And it's so crazy, because when she was in my house, bro, and when she came to my door, I had no idea who the hell it was. And it turns out I was with this girl one night. Like, it was just so crazy to me. Advice of the freaking night, because right now, well, it's 2:46 in the morning, but I still consider the night for me because I haven't slept yet. God damn. Jesus. Do not let nobody in your freaking house. Like, someone dead ass could have just... like, could have been a setup or something. Like, you know, people do that. Like, they literally, like, act out a scene as if the girl needs help, and then some big-ass man comes and pushes her out the way and robs my house, or you don't even know. Anything crazy possible. Like, yo, it's so smoky in here. Like, you never know what could have happened, and, like, I don't even know why they're in my house. I guess it's because, like, as a female, if I was out on the street by myself asking for help, I would... want help, you know? But I don't know, man. Like, she did need help, but, like, she wasn't taking the help that we were offering her, so, you know, like, you can't stay here, boo. Bye. But yeah, man, that was so crazy. I've never been in something like that. And I recently moved in my apartment in May, so, like, it's still pretty fresh to me. And I always feel like people are watching. It's like, I'm on the ground. So, like, if you're outside of my window right now, you're standing, like, you can see your legs down, and, like, I always feel like someone's just peeking in my window. But yeah, no cap, I'm so paranoid. But anyways, like, yeah, that was just so crazy. Like, never again would I ever let someone in my house. Oh my god, I'm sorry. But, like, yeah, no cap, like, that was, like, something else. I was shook. I'm really high right now. But yeah, guys, that was basically story time. I'm actually so tired. I need to go sleep. I didn't finish this list, though, but, you know. So, yo, go like, comment, subscribe. I have more videos on the motherfucking way. So, y'all stay tuned. Turn on your post notification bells. Thanks for watching.